My name is Molefi Olufemi Henderson. I am a super senior at the WIC Young Men's Leadership Academy. I am 19 years old, and my aspirations are to be an anthropology professor.
You know, Molefi came in already having a year of high school under his belt. I believe he was at Apex High School, and he made a choice, you could say in midstream, you know, to do something different. And again, he's taken full advantage of it, and he immersed himself in more effectively than most students that have been here, you know, the entire time.
My teachers were great. The class sizes were really, really small at the time. I had like 8 people in my largest class was probably like 8 people in the class. I had a class, there were only 4 of us in there.
Establishing a brotherhood is a big part of our school. It's a part of our creed. You know, one of the lines on our creed is, I am my brother's keeper. So when someone comes in his position as a 10th grader, it can be kind of daunting, I would imagine, to kind of come into an established brotherhood of guys who have known each other oftentimes since the 6th grade. But I think he came in, he brought his own personality and his own flavor that really added value to the cohort that he's a part of.
There was no outsider feeling. It was always a brotherhood. As soon as I came here, as soon as I said the creed with everybody, it was always acceptance.
One of the neat things about him, I think we created a handshake like within his first few moments here, and he was one of the few students that I did that with because he was a new student. He wasn't with the cohort that was here, so it was a way to get him into our school community and make him feel like he was just as much a part as the other ninth graders that had already been here.
My capacity in terms of able to do the work didn't change, but my attitude towards getting the work done did. So I started to prosper a lot more.
Molefi has taken advantage of what we have to offer here at the Men's Academy, but make no mistake about it, everything that he's accomplished, everything that he has done is because of Molefi's efforts.
Everything has been about either getting A's or seizing a moment. So I think the first opportunity I took here was the every year there's a magnet school fair, and that was the first opportunity I took for the school to go out and speak on behalf of the school. And when I did that the first time, I received joy from it because it just made me feel good to be able to speak about something with pride and have it actually be real, actually be true, and actually be leading other people to where I found prosperity at.
He's committed to the things that he participates in, even more so in the past year. I've seen him be committed to coming to tutoring, committed to coming to even a group that I've helped sponsored, Helping Hands, and showing up to be interested in those students' lives.
I would say that almost every teacher in my life made a difference because I feel like when you meet people, you take a part of them with you. Every single one of my teachers put a piece of me in. Like, I remember when I first learned the word hopefully, it was in kindergarten. My teacher said it, and I was stuck on it, and that made me hopeful. I learned the meaning of it, and it kind of made me a hopeful person.
So Molefi really benefited, I think, from being a part of a small class environment. I remember when I taught him in Math 3, it's only 10 students in the room, so his personality and his energy was able to really help drive that class.
At the end of that semester that I took his class, he told me, never let anyone blow out the light. Meaning, you are shining, you are a light, you're doing things, you're going places. Don't let anyone take you off of your path. Don't let anyone make you stray from who you are.
And the thing that strikes me the most about Molefi is his ability to connect with every human being. It doesn't matter who they are, race, color, creed, gender, it doesn't matter. Molefi, he's a people person.
I took the psychology of the African American community last semester, and this was probably one of the toughest classes I've taken. And it required every 5 weeks a 8 to 10 page paper on a book He gave us 5 books to choose from, and we had to read the book and do a critique of the book.
It's a great school anyway, and some students choose to take real advantage of it, and Malefi is one of those. So he's one of our fifth year super seniors, and he has really taken full advantage of the partnership that we have with St. Augustine's in fulfilling his, what do you have now, almost a junior status?
No, I'm actually already a junior.
Already a junior.
I have 61 already. I already have 61 credits. I should be finishing with 78, 79 credits.
Wow, yeah. And most of our kids graduate with, you know, anywhere between 30 and 45. And here he is pushing 70.
My first internship, I wanted to do it at the Museum of History, because right when I came here, I knew I wanted to major in history or something around that, because I loved it. History is my favorite subject. It will always be my favorite subject. Culture is just so intriguing to me.
He's doing an internship in history, so he is so excited about what he's finding out and what he's learning. So when he finds something that he's excited about, he puts his all into it. So that's one of the things that I like about Malefi.
And I kind of fell in love with the whole concept of the way people do and act and move and speak and react, because I feel like there's a lot of merit in that, and there's a lot of things that we can deduce from that, and we can take those things and try to make our society better.
Now he's interning in that atmosphere, and if you start a conversation with him about it, you better be ready for a conversation, because he's going to tell you everything he knows about it. And just much like his smile now, he's going to be smiling the whole time during that story, telling you about that. And that shows you someone that's really bought into who they want to be. They found their identity, and they're bold and making that statement. This is my identity, and it's what I want to pursue. And please enjoy it with me.
Through the opportunities that I'm doing now, I know that when I leave college, I'll be able to get a job in the field that I have a major in the field that I wanted to be in, because of the connections I have.
Malefi is everything that we could want in a student here at the Wake Young Men's Leadership Academy, and I just wish that I could clone him. It would really, really make for a wonderful environment, which we have, but he has, he's made it easy to be principal here.
Thank you.